Hello dear students, how are you?
I hope you all are good. Now in today's lecture of our periodic classification of elements, okay, we will discuss here, as you know, in previous lecture we saw atomic size, okay, and I already told atomic size, okay, whatever atomic size in a period decreases from left to right, and now we have to discuss what will happen regarding your atomic size in a group, okay, downside, what will happen from top to bottom, okay. So see here, atomic size increases from top to bottom, okay, or we can say or moving down in a group. So why it is like this? Because number of shell downside, each one shell will increases in a group. That's why what will happen, atomic size increases down to the group, or we can say from top to bottom. Okay, now here we will concentrate on regarding this. So beta, as you wrote, what will be the reason behind this, why your atomic size, yes, why atomic size increases down to the group. Okay, see, we will discuss next point, isoelectronic ions, or we can say spaces, isoelectronic ions, or we can say spaces. What will be the isoelectronic ions or spaces? So as you know, isoelectronic ions or spaces means what? It can say iso means similar, same number of electrons. Iso means what? Iso means what, beta? Similar, or we can say same, and electrons. So same number of, or we can say similar number of what, beta? Electrons. Okay, these are what here, isoelectronic spaces. Okay, but have different magnitude of nuclear charge. Whatever these isoelectronic spaces have different magnitude of nuclear charge, are called as what, beta? Isoelectronic spaces. So see, suppose if you are thinking about this, say Na plus, thereafter suppose if you are considering Mg2 plus, and here F minus, these are what? Ions. Now we have to check whether these are isoelectronic spaces or not. Okay, so see here, as you know, sodium atomic number, yes, 11. This plus means minus 1 electron, so 11 minus 1, here how much? 10 electrons, understood. As you know, magnesium atomic number 12, so these 2 plus means minus 2 is equal to 10 electrons. Suppose if you are thinking about your fluoride ion, so what, beta? 9, fluorine atomic number what? 9. Here this minus, so minus means what? Plus 1, okay, so here how much, beta? 10 electrons. Okay, so these are, we can say, as isoelectronic spaces. I hope you understood this concept regarding isoelectronic spaces. Okay, so here we will discuss now variation of ionic size among the isoelectronic spaces. Variation of what, beta? Ionic size. So that we will discuss here. Pay attention. See, you have to write this point, variation of ionic size. See, variation of ionic sites.
Okay.
Say variation of ionic size among the isoelectronic spaces.
ठीक है. So see here what will happen. As you know, along the period when there is an effective nuclear charge increases, so obviously ionic radius will decreases. ठीक है. So therefore isoelectronic spaces with the maximum positive charge. Okay, therefore, what beta? Therefore, isoelectronic spaces, in isoelectronic spaces with maximum positive charge will have smaller size. Okay, you can mention here, okay, whatever I told now, okay, regarding your isoelectronic spaces, variation in ionic size. So beta, we will discuss here. Suppose if we discuss here some examples, Al plus 3, okay, Mg 2 plus, okay, then Na plus. Now here, what beta? Yes, maximum positive charge is what? Smaller ionic size. So your, what will be here? Yes. L plus 3 is what? Minimum in size. Or we can we can arrange one order also among this. Yes, your Na plus is greater in size than your Mg 2 plus than your what beta? L plus 3. Understood? More the charge, okay, more the positive charge, smaller is that ion. Understood? So like that we can write here order of ionic size here. I hope you understood this. Now see, we will discuss here few more examples. So before that I told regarding covalent radius, metallic radius, van der Waal radius. So beta, you can write here among this covalent radius means regarding your covalent compounds. So as you know, the bond between non-metal and non-metal is what? Your covalent bond. Okay, metallic bond and what? Van der Waal. Van der Waal radius we defined for only inert gases. We saw in previous lecture with diagrammatically. Okay, now regarding radius of that, okay, so see here, radius of, you can write radius of beta van der Waal radius is greater than your what? Radius of metallic radius than what? Covalent radius. Okay, it is a part of competition, so you must know van der Waal because it is for defined only for non-bonded state. Okay, non-bonded state, therefore this radius is greater, thereafter metallic and thereafter what? Your covalent radius. Okay, so it is very much important regarding your isoelectronic spaces also. So now we will discuss here some more spaces. So you can write here, suppose you, if you want to derive an order between like this, say K plus, Ca2 plus, okay, H2 minus and what with a Cl minus. Now among these spaces, which one is smaller in size and which one is what? Largest atomic size, or we can say ionic size. These are ions, so we will define here what? Ionic size. Okay, so for this, whenever like that question will come, at that time see here, we have to simply write, or we have to do some calculation regarding Z by E ratio. So see here, we will write here, say spaces, okay,
species. So as you know, which species here? Yes, K plus, Ca2 plus, H2 minus, Cl minus. These are our what? Species. Okay. Now here you must know Z and Z is what? Atomic number and number of electrons in each and every species here you must know. Okay. Now after this you have to find out Z by E ratio. Okay. So see here. First, regarding Z of your K plus, yes, first Z of your potassium, how much? Yes, 19 beta. And number of electrons now, can you tell me? Number of electrons, so got 19, so here plus charge, so minus 1 means how much? 18. So Z by A ratio, yes, 19 divided by 18. So you can calculate. And you will get answer here 1.05 something. Okay, Ca2 plus, as you know, Z atomic number of this calcium 20. So 2 plus means 2 minus, yes, 18. So how was your Z by E ratio? Like this, 20 by 18. So you can better calculate near about, you will get 1.1. Okay, now Z for your sulfur, how much? Yes, 16. Here what? 2 minus means 2 plus, so 18. So you can do the calculation Z by ratio as like this, that is Z by 16. 16 by 18, how much? Yes, 0.88. and Cl minus, regarding Cl minus, 17. So minus means what? Plus 1 electron, so 18. I hope you understood this. Okay, now what? 17 by 18, yes, you will get what? Nearly about 0.9, yes, 0.94. Now, one more here important part. Beta, you have to write this completely. Okay? So, you have to mention here one of the important trend. So, write down that trend also. Say, I am writing here. Or I will beta mention here. Okay, say atomic radius increases with decrease in Z by E ratio. Okay, decrease in Z by E ratio. So among these, atomic radius increases with decrease in, means Zachi value minimum. Okay, atomic radius Zachi value minimum, Zachi size ka just. So what will be the here order? Now your final order becomes here like this. This beta H2 minus, thereafter what? Cl minus. Okay, thereafter what? Yes, K plus, and last your what? Yes, last is what? Ca2 plus. Understood? Okay, obviously it will help you a lot. Understood? Whenever your negative charge is also there and positive some space is also there, so you can do with the help of Z by E ratio, and with the help of the Z by E ratio we can predict the actual ionic size, whether it is increase or whether it is decrease. Okay, understood? See here, we will discuss now our next point. So here you may now got some idea regarding this. Say, means whatever your negative part having a highest atomic size as compared to what? As compared to your positive. Okay, so you may write order, the radius of anion is greater than radius of parent atom. then your what radius of beta cation point. So this thing also you can write here. Suppose if you're thinking about Na minus is greater than Na, then what Na plus. Okay, understood.
ठीक है, as a normal example if you are going to discussing here. ठीक है,
now beta we will discuss here next point about periodic classification of elements, that is say metallic and non-metallic character. See what beta? Yes, see, metallic and non-metallic character. So concentrate on this point. As you know, regarding your metal and non-metals, generally metals they have possesses what, 1, 2, or 3 valence electrons. Okay, they have tendency to lose their electrons. Okay, and to form what, a positive ion. So we call it as a what, electropositivity. Okay, electropositive metals. Okay, or we can say electropositive characters. Okay, and non-metals, as you know, generally they have in outermost shell then up to 4 to 8 valence electron, and it has a tendency to accept electrons. Okay, and forms which ions, negative ions. So whatever I am saying, that also you have to write. What I told regarding your metals, and what I am going, and now only I told regarding your non-metals. Okay, understood. So metal have tendency to lose electron, forming positive ions. So we call it as the electropositive character. And non-metals having 4 to 8 valence electrons. So they want, they are tendency to accept electrons to form what, negative ions. And we call it as what, electronegativity or electronegative character. Okay. Now we will discuss here first what will happen, means here variation. Okay. Variation in period. Okay, about metallic and non-metallic character. Okay, see here, as we move across a period, or we can say from left to right, metallic character decreases, metallic character decreases, and non-metallic character what beta increases. Okay, so it is you have to mention this beta. When we move across a period, or across a period, or from left to right. Okay, left to right, what will happen? Yes, what will happen beta? Yes, metallic character decreases, whereas non-metallic character increases. Where, while moving from left to right in a periodic table. Okay, now suppose if you are thinking regarding your period second, so we will here give an example also. Suppose, as you know, second period. Okay, in second period, suppose if you are thinking, so as you know, lithium, yes, then what beta, beryllium. Okay, then boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, carbon family, nitrogen, oxygen family. Okay, fluorine. Now these are what, lithium and beryllium, these are what beta? Yes, metal boron, carbon, we can say as a here.
What?
Boron, we can say here as a metalloid. Carbon is strictly non-metal. Okay. Means up to this, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine. So these are what? Non-metals. So like that, non-metallic character in a pyrate, what will happen? Yes, increases. So obviously downside in a group, what? Decreases, non-metallic character. Okay. Now see, from this data, you will come to know, in extreme left hand side there is a metals, and extreme right hand side of the periodic table there are non-metals. Okay. Understood this? Now suppose if you are giving explanation about variation in a group, so that also we will discuss. Okay. Variation in a about metallic and non-metallic character. Okay. So say second, variation, yes beta, variation in group. So variation in a group, now only we discuss on moving down to the group. You have to write on moving down to the group, yes, metallic character increases, yes, metallic character increases. Okay. Whereas non-metallic character, what? Decreases down to the group, or we can say from top to bottom. Okay. Or we can say here, down to the group, electropositive character increases. Okay. Suppose if you are thinking some elements here, Limca, soda, Pepsi, che, rhubarb, cassia, far. Okay, you will write up to cesium only, because francium is what? Or francium is radioactive element. Okay. Now, as we will discuss here, down to the group, metallic character what? Yes, metallic character increases. Okay. Or we can say electropositive character increases. And suppose if you are thinking about your halogens, okay, halogens, if you are thinking non-metallic character regarding say fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, these are what? Non-metallic. Or we can see here, mostly what? Or we can say highly non-metallic character here, your fluorine, highly non-metallic character, and here what? Least non-metallic character. So from this data, what we conclude here, fluorine is the most electronegative element, while cesium is what? Most electropositive element. So you have to mention this data in your notebook. Hope you are removing notes also. Okay. What we conclude here, your fluorine is what? Most electronegative element, and cesium is what? Electropositive element here. Okay. And as you know, some there are non-metallic, or you can say semi-metals also there, metalloids also there. Okay. Boron, like examples we can mention, boron, silicon, germanium, astat, your arsenic, stibium, polonium. These are what? Semi-metals, or we can say the metalloids. Okay. Now we will discuss here nature of oxides. Okay. See here regarding what? Nature of oxides. I hope you understood this. What your metallic character, non-metallic character. Okay. Keep in mind this. Now say about nature of oxides. See, nature of oxides. So basically one thing you know beta. Okay, bases, or we can say oxides of metals are bases, and oxides of non-metals are what? Acidic. Okay, oxides of metals are basic and oxides of non-metals are acidic. As you know, Na2O, okay, or non-metal SO3, SO2, so these are what? Yes, acidic. Okay, so in a period, we will write variation in a period and in a group. In a period, what is a trend in our periodic table? So write down in a period, the basic nature, okay, basic nature decreases, okay, whereas the acidic nature of oxide increases. In a period, beta, in a period, what will happen? The basic nature of oxides decreases, while acidic nature is increases. Okay, acidic nature of oxide increases from left to right, or we can say across a period. Now in a group, what will happen beta? In a group, say, in a group, okay, the basic nature of oxides increases, because number of shell increases, while acidic nature of oxide, what beta? Yes, acidic nature of oxide decreases. Or we can say vice versa of this. Okay, one increase, one decrease, like that. Down to the group, what will happen? Metallic character increases. So obviously down to the group, basic nature of that oxide, it increases. And along the period, as you know, non-metallic character increases. So non-metallic oxides are what? Acidic. So non-metallic oxide in a period, say acidic nature of oxide is increases. I hope you understood. You have to pay attention on this, because it is very much important for your competitive aspects also. Okay, now we will discuss regarding formulas. Okay, yeah, we will take one period as an example. Okay, so see, suppose if you are thinking about of third period, okay, third period, if you are thinking about third period, so see, suppose I will write here Na2O, okay, MgO, thereafter Al2O3, SiO2, then your P2O5, okay, SO3, and what beta? Cl2O7. So these are third period elements and their oxides. So in a period, acidic nature of oxide increases. So see, then first is what? Basic. Okay, so Na2O, these are what? Yes, these are here strongly basic beta. Strongly basic. These are what? Yes, basic. Okay, L2O3 we can call it as amphoteric. Amphoteric means what? They are showing, or we can say they will react with both acids, okay, as well as bases. Amphoteric nature. Okay. SiO2 we can write here as a weakly acidic. What beta? We can mention here upside. Weakly acidic. Okay. P2O5 is little bit acidic. We can say only acidic. We can write strongly acidic. And whatever you see, L2O7 is what? Very strongly acidic. Okay. So like that, we have to keep in mind the order regarding third period. I hope you understood this. Okay. Regarding your today's lecture. Understood. So whatever next part beta, that we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you very much. Take care and stay safe.